Oh, it's now being recorded.
वागत्थ रूपेण व्यवहार क्रियते भा धातो हो अप्रत्ययत्वात् ता प्रत्ययत्वेन भाषा शब्दस्य व्युत्पत्ति ही सर्वेभ्य सब इदम ज्ञातमस्ति यत् मनुष्यः मानवः सामाजिक त्वेन सर्वत्र विराजते मैन इज ए रेशनल एनिमल एंड इट इज लैंग्वेज व्हिच मेक्स द पीपल मैन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम अदर्स एज यू ऑल नो वी हैव ए वर्स ट्रेडिशनल वर्स आहार निद्रा भय मैथुन च सामान्यमेतत् पशुभिर् नराणां धर्मो हि तेषां अधिको विशेषः धर्मेण हीना पशुभिः समानः The dharma which distinguishes men, human beings, from the rest of the animals. Here, we have language which distinguishes human beings from the rest of the creatures of the world. So immediately the question arises, why there are so many languages in the world? Number one. Then, why there is so much differences between languages? When languages created? Is there a relation between the languages? So when all these questions arose in the mind of the human beings, they are started an investigation regarding language. And that laid the foundation of linguistic analysis. As you know, from very early times, there has been attempts to know about the origin of language. Rugvede idam vartate daivim vacham ajananta devaha tang viswarupaha pasava vadanti. Yaska in the 8th century AD, BC, made a very good analysis of deriving words from roots. Panini in during 5th century BC made a descriptive analysis of Sanskrit language in the most scientific manner. And perhaps Yaska and Panini laid the foundation of linguistic analysis in India. If you go beyond the geographical limit of India, we come across the contribution of the Greeks to linguistic analysis in the ancient world. Now, if language is to be analyzed, what name is to be given? We have two names. One is philology, the other is linguistics. Language is studied in three different ways. We have descriptive study of language, which is called vivaranatmaka adhyayanam, athava varnanatmaka adhyayanam. We have historical study, aithihasika adhyayanam, and we have comparative study, tulanatmaka adhyayanam. Panini makes a descriptive study of Sanskrit language, both its Vedic form as well as its classical form. In historical linguistics, you have to study the origin and development of a language, of a particular language, in different periods of time. I give you an example. Odia word, jio, meaning kanya, has come from Prakrit dhida. And dhida word has come from Sanskrit duhita. Similarly, in order to know the
origin of the Odia word ga, meaning village, you have to search for Sanskrit equivalent gramo. So from Sanskrit grama to Odia ga, from Sanskrit duhita to Prakrit dhida to Odia jio, we have a historic development. If such type of developments are studied in language, they are called historical study of language. If you come to comparative study of language, comparison is always made between two things which have some similarities between themselves. Sanskrit, Greek, and Latin, the three languages have some comparison among themselves. Therefore, we can make a comparative study of Sanskrit and Greek, Greek and Latin, Latin and
Yes.
Sanskrit. With these three types of studies, that is descriptive, historical, and comparative, we can make a complete study of languages. As has already been told in the introduction by Dr. Pradhan, we have four different parts of study of linguistics. We have Dhvani Tattvam, phonetics, Shabda Tattvam, morphology, Vakya Tattvam, syntax, and Artha Tattvam, semantics. Dhvaneha Visleshanam अध्ययनं च ध्वनितत्त्वे विधीयते यथा पाणिनीय शिक्षाम् उक्तम् आत्मा बुद्ध्या समेत्यार्थान् मनोयुक्त विवक्षया मनः कायाग्निना सन्ति सप्रेरयति मारुतम् मारुतस्तु रसीचरन् मन्द्रं जनयते स्वरम् सस्वरो सहस्रो मूर्ध्नाभिहताः वक्त्रमापद्य मारुतः अनेन प्रकारेण ध्वनेः सृष्टिर् भवति पाणिनी शिक्षायामपि इदम् उक्तम् केन प्रकारेण कस्य वर्णस्य उच्चारणं विधीयते अक्व विसर्जनीयानां कण्ठः इतु यथानां ताडु उपपद्यानां औष्टौ ऋतुरसानां मूर्धा ऋतुलसानां दन्ताः एतेषां वर्णानां कथम् उच्चारणं भवति कश्च आभ्यन्तरप्रयत्नः कश्च तेषां वर्णानां बाह्यप्रयत्नः सर्वमिदम् अध्ययनं ध्वनितत्वे आगच्छति तथैव शब्दतत्व मध्ये शब्दानां आकृतिः शब्दानां संगठनं च विधीयते वाक्यतत्वे वाक्यगठनस्य रीतिः अर्थतत्वे अर्थस्य रूपम् अर्थस्य उच्चः अर्थपरिवर्तनस्य कारणानि एतानि सर्वाणि अधीयन्ते तथा उदाहरणस्वरूपतः कथ्यते अ अ आ आ इत्यादीनां वर्णानां ध्वनीनाम् उच्चारणं विश्लेषणम् अध्ययनं ध्वनितत्वे अन्तर्भुक्तं भवति उत्कलभाषायां रामशब्दस्य राम अ रामकु अथवा रामं राम प्लस अम् पठितं पठ तक्त पठित इति अनेन प्रकारेण विश्लेषणं क्रियते तत्त्व विश्लेषणं शब्दतत्त्वान्तर्गतं भवति संस्कृतरागशब्दस्य मौलिकः अर्थः कः अस्यार्थस्तु भवति अनुरागः कदाचित् क्रोधः कदाचित् रक्तिमा कदाचित् कटुस्वादः इत्यादयः विभिन्नाः अर्थाः वर्तन्ते इदम् अध्ययनं तु अर्थतत्त्वस्य अन्तर्गतं भवति तदनन्तरम् आगच्छति कथं भाषायाः सृष्टिः अभवत् विषयेऽस्मिन् बहवः मतवादाः वर्तन्ते तेषु चत्वारः मतवादाः प्रमुखाः भवन्ति वाव् वाव् थियोरि बिओडब्ल्यू डब्ल्यू वाव् वाव् थियोरि पुह् पुह् थियोरि पि डबल् ओ एच् पुह् पुह् थियोरि डिङ्ग् डङ्ग् थियोरि ये हे हो थ्योरी दीज आर द फोर प्रिंसिपल थ्योरीज regarding the origin of language. In addition to that, we have some other theories. We have called contact theory or Samparka Siddhantaha. We have gestural theory or Ingita Siddhantaha. Apita evolutionary theory. Shabdasya bhasayaha vikasa siddhantaha. Sarvapratamam bhasayaha katham srushti abhut. Ayam tu ekaha bismoddipakaha visayaha. From time immemorial, man has been inquisitive about the origin of language, about the creation of language. And in spite of his continuous effort, it has not been possible to find out a single answer which is responsible, which can adequately answer to the question regarding the origin of language. No single theory can explain the origin of language in its entirety. It is the opinion of many religious texts that languages have been created by God. Daivim vacham ajananta devaha tang viswarupaha pasavo vadanti iti hindu shastranam matam. The Christian's Bible believes that it is the English language which was created first. So also is the case with Jains, who believe that Prakrit was the language which was created first by the God. The believers in Buddhism, the adherents of Buddhism, they believe that this Pali language which was created by the God. So that is why Buddha Deva, while preaching his religion, told that Pariksha Bhikkhavo Grahyam Madhavacho Natu Gauravat. You have to spread the language, spread the sermon given by me to the language of the people. See, the first theory, the Bavo theory, imitates the sound produced by the dogs. We have bow ow is a sound that is created by dog. Similarly, in languages we see the crow has its own sound, the cuckoo has its own sound. Kokilaha, the cuckoo iti sabda karoti, iti cuckoo sabda se adharena, cuckoo in Anglo bhashayam cuckoo sabda ha vinirmitaha. Tataha ketana kathayanti bhasayaha utpattihi tameva adharikutya tameva sabdam adharikutya je sabdaha je dhanayaha pranibhihi srushtaha pasubhi srushtaha. So by imitating such sounds produced by animals, language has been created. But the number of words is so less in language, number of such words is so less in the language that it can hardly be called a complete language. So we have another theory, we are called a poof-poof theory. When there is sorrow, we immediately produce a sound like poof-poof, choo-choo. So that language also, those words have also contributed for the creation of languages. Jak-jak in Hindi or ding-dong in any language, chak-chak in Odia, such words have a very intimate relationship with the language. English jig-jag, meaning a curved way. Those languages, those words also create languages. When human beings go for physical labor, they produce some sounds. Like when they sail a boat in the deep sea, they produce a sound like yo-ho-ho. Yo-ho-ho theory has come from that. But another important theory regarding contact theory, which tells that when human beings came in contact with each other, they created the language. But how did they, now the general, the immediate question comes, how did they talk to each other? Even some people call that through gesture language has been created. But if you take a judicious view, you have to come to the conclusion that Samanvita Siddhanta, if you take a holistic view, all these theories, from divine origin theory to Eheho theory to Ding Dong theory to Root theory to Poo Poo theory to Vibrational theory to Contact theory to Gesture theory, if you mingle all these theories together, that will give you a complete shape of language, and that therefore no particular theory is responsible for the creation of a language. All these theories taken together can contribute to the creation of language. Now, if you come to the division of languages, see, we have two different types of classifications of classification language. We have morphological classification. First is morphological classification. This morphological classification or Sabda Sangatana Mulaka Vibhagaha is also called as syntactical classification. Vakya Sangatana Mulaka Vibhagaha Vibhajanam. This morphological or syntactical classification is again divided into two types. We have inorganic and organic. Inorganic called aparivartaniyam, organic called parivartaniyam. The inorganic is also called isolating or a positional. Organic is again divided into two types. You have agglutinating and inflectional or amalgamating. Glue means the substance that is used to join things, glutinate. We use glue to join two pieces of woods. So if you join two different parts of species, that is called agglutinating. This agglutinating is again divided into three types. We have prefix agglutinating, suffix agglutinating, and infix agglutinating. It's aparivartaniya bhasa, Anglo bhasayam, isolating athava positional bhasa iti kathyate. Sabdasya vakya sthiti tasya artham suchayati. Yadyapi sabdasya rupagatam parivartanam bhavati tathapi sabdasya vakye avasthiti tasya visesham artham prakashayati. It is this position of a word in a language which determines its meaning. Suppose we have a word in the beginning, it has a different meaning. If the same word is used in the middle, it has some other meaning. If it is used at the end, it has some other meaning. So it is positional. Depending on the position of a word in the vakya or sentence, the meaning is determined. Clear? Then we have organic languages or parivartaniya bhasha. This parivartaniya bhasha has different types of parivartanas for different types of changes. We have akritigatam parivartanam, upasargaha, anusargaha, vata antasargasya yogena, bhasayaha sabdanam parivartanam bhavati, parivartanaya bhasa api, punasya bhagadvayena vivakta vartate. Prathame vibhage haplophrastic or polysynthetic bhasa iti kathyate. Sadharanataya उत्कलभाषायां एकम एकम शब्दम संयुज्य वाक्यम विरच्यते। यदि शब्दम उज्जित्वा एकम शब्दम त्यक्त्वा अन्य एकस्य शब्दस्य प्रयोगः क्रियते तदा वाक्यस्य परिवर्तनं भवति, रूपपरिवर्तनं भवति, अपि च अर्थपरिवर्तनं भवति। परंतु ग्रीनलैंडिश भाषायां एतादृशी अवस्था वर्तते। मैं उदाहरण देते आउलिसोर ई आर्तोर स्वार्पो इति ग्रीन देशिया भाषा, ग्रीनलैंड देशिया देशिया भाषायां अस्य अर्थः भवति आउलिसोर ई आर्तोर स्वार्पो सह मत्स्यान आनेतुम गमिष्यति। वाक्यस्य जे विभागः वर्तन्ते, जे शब्दः वर्तन्ते, तान् शब्दान् विभाजनं कर्तुं वयं न शक्नुमः। आउलिसोर ई अर्थोर स्वार्पो इति यद्यपि साधारणतया प्रतिभाति, अत्र बहवः शब्दाः वर्तन्ते, वस्तुतः तत्र बहवः शब्दाः न सन्ति। यदि एतेषां शब्दानां वयं विभागं करिष्यामः तदा पिन्ने स्वार्पक इति कथ्यते स गच्छति, आवलिशोर मत्स्यान् आनेतुं, प्यार्तोर गमिष्यति। पतु शब्दा शब्दानां सम्बन्धः एतादृशो वर्तते तथा साधारणतया तान् शब्दान् विभागीकर्तुं वयं न शक्नुमः। परिवर्तनीयासु भाषासु यथा मया पूर्वम् उक्तं संयोजिका भाषा अथवा अग्लुटिनेट लैंग्वेज, सम्मिश्रिका भाषा अमलगमेटिक लैंग्वेज अथवा इंफ्रेस लैंग्वेज इति भेदद्वयं वर्तते। संयोजिका भाषा पुनश्च प्रीफिक्स एग्लुटिनेटिंग पूर्वपद संयोजिका, सफिक्स एग्लुटिनेटिंग परपद संयोजिका प्रत्यय संयोजिका इति भवति। इनफिक्स एग्लुटिनेटिंग भाषा वर्तते अंतसर्ग संयोजिका भाषा, तत्र किं भवति अंतसर्ग तु अंतसर्गस्य भेदद्वयं वर्तते, इंटरनल इन्फेक्शन एक्सटर्नल इन्फेक्शन। क्यू टी एल आंग्ल भाषायां क्यू टी एल इति वर्णत्रयं वर्तते। यदि क्यू टी एल मध्ये क्यू इति वर्णस्य परम ए, टी वर्णात् परम आई इति वर्णानां व्यवहारः क्रियते चेत् तर्हि कातिल इति शब्दः आगच्छति। कातिल कतल क्यूटीएल इति अपरिवर्तनीयं रूपं, यदि तत्र अंतसर्गस्य अंतर्भावः क्रियते तर्हि क्यूटीएल इति शब्दस्य कातिल कतल इति अनेक शब्दाः आगच्छन्ति। भाषा परिवार भाषाया भाषा पृथिव्याम जे भाषा वर्तन्ते इफ यू लुक एट दोज लैंग्वेजेस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड देयर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस आज इनऑर्गेनिक और ऑर्गेनिक एग्लुटिनेटिंग इन्फ्लेक्शनल अमलगमेटिंग द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस ऑल द लैंग्वेजेस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड हैव बीन grouped under some family. Just as the son, daughter belonging to the same family have the same physical feature, same gene, same type of learning. Similarly, depending upon the similarities between languages, the languages of the world have been grouped under 13 heads. We have in total 13 families of languages. Number one, Indo-European Bharopiya Bhasha Parivaraha. Two, Semitic Hamitic Parivaraha. Three, Ural Altaic Parivaraha. Four, Dravidian Parivaraha. Five, Austric Parivaraha. Six, Tibeto Chinese Parivaraha. Seven, Bantu Parivaraha, BANTU. Eight, Bushman Parivaraha, BUSHMAN. Nine, Sudanese Parivaraha. Ten, Caucasian Parivaraha, CAUCASIAN. 11, American Parivaraha. 12, Uttari Bhasha Samuha. 13, unclassified languages. Bharopiya Parivara, Indo-European languages, as the name suggests, this language family has occupied a vast field, vast geographical land of the world. Bharat, almost the entire Indian subcontinent, the eastern side of Asia, and most of the parts of Europe, almost the entire North America, and some portion of the South America come under this Indo-European family of languages. We shall deal with the Indo-European family of languages afterwards in detail. Then we have Semitic, Hamitic language family. It actually, there are two subfamilies of Semitic family and Hamitic family. Some people consider these two as two different families, but considering their mutual similarities, it is judicious to consider them as one family. In both the subfamilies, the pronoun is almost same. The verbs have the similar type. That is why Semitic and Hamitic are to be taken as one. Then, see, this qualification is either geographical or linguistic. Then we have the third is one is Ural Altaic. Just as Semitic Hamitic are considered to be two, Ural Altaic is also considered to be two subfamilies, Ural and Altaic. Ural is again divided into two branches. We have Finno-Ugric and Samoyed. Finnic, Ugric, and Parmian languages are grouped under Finno-Ugric, or Finnish, Karelian, Vetis, Estonian. They come under the Ural family. In Altaic, the Turkish and Mongolian Manchu language is also called Altaic language. Turkish language has four different parts. We have Western, Southern, Central, and Eastern. Actually, 20 languages are included under the Ural Altaic. In Dravidian language, we have Tamil, Malayalam, Kannad, then Tulu. Tulu is a language spoken in Tamil, just as Sambalpuri is as ancient as Odia. Similarly, Tulu is also as ancient as Tamil. We have Kodugu, we have Badag, we have Tod, we have Kot, Gundi, Kuruk, Malto, Kui, Arkandhi, Kolami, Telugu, Brahui. There are 15 languages which are grouped under Dravidian language. And since all these languages are limited to the southern part of India, we give a very brief discussion about those languages now. Tamil is the oldest language of all southern South Indian languages. Its literature is available from 3rd century BC. You know, Government of India has declared Tamil as the first classical language of India. Malayalam is spoken in Kerala, Kannada in Mysore. Kannada in Mysore, Telugu in Andhra. Brahui is spoken in Balochistan. Austric language has two subdivisions, Austroasiatic and Austronesian. Austroasiatic languages are spoken in Nicobar Island, then in some part of Mon Khmer and Munda. Then Austronesian has again two different parts, Indonesian or Malayan and Oceanian. Tibeto-Chinese, as is evident from the name, we have Tibetan and Chinese. So Tibeto-Chinese has four different subdivisions, Tibeto-Himalayan, then North Assam, Central Assam, and South Assam languages. Then we come to Bantu. This is a prefix agglutinative language. The difference between the branches of this language is very, very negligible. And this language is mostly spoken in South Africa. Sudan is spoken in Sudan. Caucasian is a prefix suffix agglutinative language family. It has two branches. We have North Caucasian and South Caucasian. This is spoken in the Caucasian mountain range. Then the American languages we have five. In geographically, we have three different branches. We have Canadian and United States of America. Canadian and United States of America. Then we have Mexican and Central America. And we have South America. Then in the hyperbolic, Sudra Uttarasya Bhasaha, we have Arctic in the Antarctica region. Then we have those languages which have not been grouped under any family, Abhivakta Bhasa Sakalaha. Then we come to the Indo-European family of languages. Indo-European family of languages, as you know, this is a branch of Indo-Hittite family. Indo-European language is a branch of Indo-Hittite family. So Indo-European languages are divided into two groups. Basing upon the change of ka sound, basing upon the change of ka sound, Indo-European languages are divided into two types, two branches. See, it is argued by the linguists that Indo-European languages have come from a common source. We have two different languages here. We have Indian languages and European languages, but they had a common source. That common source is called Star IE or Mula Bharopiya Bhasha. From the Mula Bharopiya Bhasha, all the Indo-European languages have come from. They think for the word 100 in Sanskrit, 100 in Odia, the Sanskrit word is Satam. So in one group, for Satam, we have two words in English. We have century and 100. Century is older than 100. So she is pronounced as sa, she is also pronounced as ka. So we have two different groups. We have Kentum and Satam. Kentum and Satam. Centum, Kentum, Satam. So in the original Indo-European language, the word was like Kamtum, Kamtum. The original word was Kamtum. So in those languages in which the original ka sound remained intact, that is called Kentum, and where the original ka sound changed to sa sound, they are called Satam. So we have in Greek we have Katon, Latin Centum, Germanic or Gothic Kund, English 100, Irish Ket, Tocharian Kat. So in all the languages, the ka sound remained as it is. In Satam, that ka changed to sa. Sanskrit is Satam, Avesta Satam, Lithuanian Simtas, Old Church Slavic Sutto. So ka sound changes to ka sound changes to sa. So basing upon these, the original sound was ka in original Indo-European, Kamtum, Kamtum, in those languages in which that original ka sound remained as ka, remained as such, they are called as Kentum languages, and in those languages in which the original Indo-European ka sound changed to sa, they are called Satam languages. In the Kentum group, we have Hittite, Greek, Italian, Celtic, Germanic, and Tocharian languages. In the Satam group, we have Indian, Iranian, Balto-Slavic, Armenian, and Albanian. For the first time under Indo-European, you are coming across a language called Hittite. Actually, Hittite language, though very old, was discovered only during the 20th century. We have an inscription in a place called Boghazkoi in Asia Minor, belonging to 13th century AD. When this inscription was discovered during 20th century, there is a revolution in the study of languages of the world. Why? are Greek and Latin. Sanskrit is the oldest language. And Sanskrit has much similarity with the language of Iran. Iran, the word in the name Iran, is a developed form of the word Aryanam. Aryanam word has been made corrupt by the word Iran. Iran is sabda sabdaha, Aryana sabdat nispannaha. Iran iti sabdaha, Aryanam iti sabdat nispanno vartate. Chita iti bhasaya saha, prayasaha chatasraha bhasaha, samyatam abahanti, Luwian, Lycian, Lydian, hieroglyphic. If you make a study of all these four languages, along with Hittite, that is called Anatolian or Laryngeal. Greek language, as you know, is an important component of Indo-European family of languages. And perhaps the Greece, ancient Greece, has contributed the most to the development of world language and world culture. Greek language is the most prominent and very rich in its literary activities. You know, just as we have in Sanskrit Ramayana and the Mahabharata, we have Homer's Iliad and Odyssey in ancient Greek. From the point of antiquity, how old is Greek language? We don't have any difficulty to admit that Greek is as ancient as Sanskrit, but its literature was written after the Vedas were written. We have Italian, Italic or Italian. Italian has three different branches. We have Latin, Oscan, and Umbrian. Germanic language has a New German and Old German. We have three branches of German. We have Eastern Germanic, we have Northern Germanic, and Western Germanic. Eastern Germanic is called Gothic. In India, if you go to ancient places, to the places having ancient heritage, you see many of the churches in India, if you go to Goa or Tamil Nadu, you see the churches are built in Gothic style. Gothic means Germanic style, old Germanic style. In the Northern Germanic branch, we have Norway, language of Norway, Sweden, Denmark, and Iceland. In Western Germanic, we have English, German language. You know, English, which has occupied a very vast land in the world geography, has come from Western Germanic branch of Germanic language family. Then we have Indo-Iranian. The Indo-Iranian, as you know, we have Indian and Iranian. Indian language, the Indian branch has three branches, Old Indo-Aryan or OIA, Middle Indo-Aryan MIA, and New Indo-Aryan NIA. Similarly, we have Old Iranian, Middle Iranian and New Iranian languages. As I've already told you, Indo-European languages have come from the mother Indo-European language, which is written as star IE, star Indo-European. That is the oldest language from which Indo-European languages have come from. This is the opinion of most of the linguists. So in the original Indo-European, we have primary vowels like O, A and O, which both with singular vowels, it is short variety and long variety. O, A, O and A, Dirgha A and Dirgha O. The neutral vowels called Swa, S, C, H, W, A. You have a neutral vowel, Swa. There are secondary vowels, E, U, Ru, Ru, Ma, Na. And we have long variety, Dirgha I, Dirgha U, Dirgha Ru, Dirgha Ru, Mo and Na. We have Dvishwara or diphthongs, O E, A E, O E, O U, A U and O U. Then we have Dirgha variety, A E, A E, O E, A U, A U and O U. Then we have plosives, Spashta, Vyanjana Dhvani. We have three types of ka sounds. We have ka, written as k, then kantha, we have written as q, and the kanthastha, qw. We have dental, ta, tha, da, dha, na, ostya, labials, pa, pa, ba, ba, ma. We have rolled, ra sound. We have lateral, la sound. We have spirants, like sa, ja, tha, and dha, s and z. These are the languages we are getting in original Indo-European. These languages are almost preserved intact in Sanskrit and Iranian languages. Now you come to the Indian languages or Indo-European, we have Indian and European. Then Indian is also called as Indo-Iranian. We have Indian and Iranian. Now we come to Indian or Aryan languages. Indian or Aryan languages, as I have already told, the Aryan languages have three time divisions. We have Old Indo-Aryan, Middle Indo-Aryan, and New Indo-Aryan. Prachina Bharati Arya Bhasha, Madhya Bharatiya Arya Bhasha, and Nutana Bharatiya and Navya Bharatiya Arya Bhasha. Prachina, Madhya Yugiya, Adhunika. Adhunika we call modern MIL, modern Indian languages. It is not a modern Indian. Modern Indian languages, or it called as ANIA, New Indo-Aryan. Sanskrit or Vedic Sanskrit and Laukika Sanskrit. Vedic Sanskrit and Laukika or classical Sanskrit, they belong to the old Indo-Aryan. Vedic Sanskrit and classical Sanskrit belong to the old Indo-Aryan group or division. Then Pali, Prakrit, and Apabhramsha, they belong to the Middle Indo-Aryan branch. Then Bengali, Hindi, Odia, Gujarati, Rajasthani, Punjabi, Ahmiya, they all belong to the modern Indo-Aryan languages. From the research that has been carried out till today, we are satisfied to tell that the earliest, the time of the Vedic Suktas may go up to 5000 BC or even beyond that. Vedic language has four divisions. We have Sangita, Brahmana, Aranyaka, and Upanishad. Sangita is again divided into four: Rig, Yajur, Saman, Atharva. Rigveda is the oldest of all the Vedic Sangitas, and even in the Rigveda, the Vamsamandala or the family books are the ancient most. And as you know, the Brahmins, they do the rituals, and the Brahmins will do the rituals. The Aranyaka are the forest texts, and Upanishad deals with Indian philosophy. In the Middle Indo-Aryan, it has three divisions again. We have one division is from 500 BC to beginning of Christian era, then from beginning of Christian era to 500 AD, then 500 to 1000 AD. The Middle Indo-Aryan or MIA, Madhya Bharati Arya Bhasha, or Pratham Arya Bharati Adya Bhasha, Madhya Bharati second, first Middle Indo-Aryan, second phase of Middle Indo-Aryan, and third phase of Middle Indo-Aryan. The first phase is called classical Sanskrit, the second phase Pali, and third phase the Prakrit. These Prakrits, as you know, have different names. We have Saurasheni, we have Maharashtri, we have Magadhi, we have Odroja Prakrit. The Maharashtri Prakrit is spoken in Maharashtra, was being spoken in Maharashtra, Saurasheni in Surasena, and Magadhi in modern Bihar and Magadha. As regard the modern Indo-Aryan languages, we have NIA or MIA, whatever you will tell it. We have different languages. We have Marathi, then we have Hindi, we have Odia, Bengali, Ohmia, we have Punjabi, Gujarati, Rajasthani, and many other, and all other languages which are not spoken by the Adivasis or the scheduled tribes and the Dravidians. Friends, till now I have given you some idea about linguistics in general. Now we have to, as regards the Vedic and the Indian Aryan language, Indian Aryan, Bharatiya Arya Bhasha, we have to be very specific about the contents of those languages. See, as I have already told you, in Bharatiya Arya Bhasha, we have three different divisions. We have Prachina Bharatiya Arya Bhasha from 1500 BC to 500 AD, then Middle Indo-Aryan from 500 AD to 1000 AD, and from 1000 AD to till date, we have the new Indo-Aryan languages. Before that, we have to study the similarities and dissimilarities among the Vedic and classical Sanskrit. which come under the old Euro, old Indo-Aryan, old Indo-Aryan. As you know, just as we have three different divisions in Aryan, old Indo-Aryan, middle Indo-Aryan, and new Indo-Aryan, in the Iranian counterpart also, we have old Iranian, middle Iranian, and new Iranian language. In the Vedic language, as you know, in the original Indo-European language, we had O, A, O, but all the three O, A, O developed as O in Sanskrit. A, A, and O changed to A in Veda. Original Indo-European, No and Mo, Antastha sounds, were deleted in Vedic language. Now, what are the basic features, important features of Vedic language then? Every language, as you know, has its own specific characteristic features. And because of those specialities, special features, each language is given a special status. You know, Vedic Sanskrit is the only language in the world which has three divisions. Just as we have Rasva, or short and long, Veda has three, Rasva, Dirgha, and Pluta. This Pluta variety of pronunciation is not found in any other language. Then, the concept of the presence of the sound, Ru. Ru is not found in use in other languages. We have in Vedic language. Then, accent, Udatta, Andatta, Swarita, this accent, the three accents are available only in the Vedas. As you know, we have a very important verse, Indra Satur Vardhaswa Mantra Hina Srato Vannato Ba Mitha Prakto Na Tamartamaha Sa Bhag Vajro Jajamani Nasti Jatendra Satur Srato Paradha. Because the Swara was changed, Indra was able to kill Vrutra. Though Vrutra himself conducted sacrifice, he was killed by Indra. The raw sound, Agni Mele, this raw sound is unique to Vedic language. Moreover, many a time we see that there is an interchangeability between the law and the raw sound. In Sanskrit Salila, we find that we have Sarira, Dantyasa, Ri Ra. Sarira means Salila. Sarira means Sarira Talabhasanu. Sarira. Sarira means water and not body. So there is interchangeability between the raw and law. And we do not have much complications with regard to Sandhi in the Vedas. Many a time you will see Haribhyanga Jahi Oka A. Sandhis are split. And we have many forms for one. Suppose Devaha, Devo, Janaha, Janasaha, Devehi, Devevi, Devo, Devevhiragamat. Then we have different forms for Tumun. We have Se, Sirna, Ase, Asen, Adhyayi, Kadhyayi. So we have, what do we see? Kartum, in place of Kartum, we have Jivitum, Jivase, Jivasen, Jibase, Asen, Kase, Kasen, different types of pratyayas are used to denote one, that is Tumun sense. Even upasargas constitute an inseparable part of the roots in the classical Sanskrit. Lokika samstabhasayam upasargasya upasarganam svatantra sthitir nasti. They constitute an inseparable part of the root or dhatu. Whereas in the Vedas, upasargas have their independent existence. Haribhyang jahi oka a. Haribhyang jahi oka a. A jahi. In Sanskrit, a jahi. It is jahi is a separate. A is separate. Separate. The seeds. Even with regard to the meaning, many times we see, see, let lakara is present in Vedic language, which is absent in classical Sanskrit. Many Vedic words are not found used in classical Sanskrit, where darshata meaning sundara, drusika means sundara, rapas meaning durbalata or disease, amura meaning buddhiman, rududara meaning kind, aktu meaning naive, amoeba means vyadhi or disease. Such things are not found in classical Sanskrit. Such words are not transferred. Then, if you make a comparison between Vedic Sanskrit and classical Sanskrit, I give you some hints. In Vedic Sanskrit, we have accent. In classical Sanskrit, we do not have any accent. Number one, we have udatta, andatta, and sarita. In Sanskrit, classical Sanskrit, we don't have any udatta, andatta, and sarita. Then ekamatra bhayat rasaha, dvimatra dirgha uchyate, trimatra trutajyayaha, vyanjanam tardhamatrakam. This plutta, we have ekamatra, dvimatra and trimatra, we have udatta, andatta, sarita, udatta, and sarita are available in Veda and not in classical Sanskrit. Rasva dirgha are available in Vedic Sanskrit. Rasva dirgha and plutta are available in Vedic Sanskrit. Plutta is absent in classical Sanskrit. Vedic Sanskrit has a ru varna, which is available in, it is not available in classical Sanskrit. Ra sound and ra sound, juhamuliya and padmaniya are available in Vedic Sanskrit. They are absent in classical Sanskrit. Then, ablaut. Ablaut means swara bhakti. Ablaut is present in Vedic Sanskrit. They are absent in classical Sanskrit. We have no hard and fast rule with regard to sandhi in the Vedas. Sandhi rules became anivarya or mandatory in Sanskrit, classical Sanskrit. For each shabda rupa, we have different words in Vedic Sanskrit, but shabda rupa in classical Sanskrit became limited. So with regard to the roots or dhatu rupa, we have many dhatus in the Vedic Sanskrit which have been reduced in classical Sanskrit. Vedic Sanskrit didn't have any distinction between Atmanepada and Parasmaipada. Even for Atmanepada, they were using Parasmaipada. For Parasmaipada, they were using Atmanepada. There are no separate rules. But in classical Sanskrit, we have specific rules for Atmanepada and Parasmaipada. In Vedic Sanskrit, we have long, loom, and lit prayoga, lit application. For any, there is no speed and tested and fast rule. For long, lingate, loom, long, litaha. You can use long, loom, and lit. In any lakaras, for any lakaras, the interchangeability of applicability between long, loom, and ling, this is not possible in classical Sanskrit. Vedic Sanskrit had 11 lakaras, including late lakara. This late lakara was absent, became absent in classical Sanskrit. Classical Sanskrit has 10 lakaras. Then I have already told that for Pumun, we have several pratyayas which are absent in classical Sanskrit. Upasargas had independent existence. They were used independently of the roots, but Upasargas became a part and parcel of root in classical Sanskrit. Then Tarat and Tamat are added even to the nouns, Kabi Taraha, Kabi Tamaha, but this is not available in classical Sanskrit. They became part of the adjective, Sundara Taraha, Sundara Tamaha. Then many words like Aktu, Amura, Ima, Uktha, Uti, Rududaraha, the Vicharshani, they all these words, Vedic words, were available in Vedic language, which are absolutely not in use in classical Sanskrit. Then we have for one word different meanings are there in Vedas. For Ari, we have Ishvara, Dharmika, Shatru, but in classical Sanskrit, Ari means simply Shatru. For Arati, we have Shatruta and Krupanata. For Arati, we have Shatru in classical Sanskrit. For Na, just like no, Na has two meanings, no and just like. This thus is absent in classical Sanskrit. Then another important question is that the Sanskrit, whether Sanskrit was a spoken language during ancient Indian days. If you analyze the Sutra of Panini, many a time Panini uses the word Bhashayam. Panini never uses the word Sanskrite or Sanskrita Bhashayam. It simply is a Bhashayam. Bhashayam means that which was current during the time of Panini. And if you analyze the Vatika Katyayana and Bhashya Patanjali, you see many a time Katyayana tells that Panini, you have committed a mistake. You have not included this word or this word or this word. So he uses the Upasankhyana Vatikam. The Upasankhyana means you have to add this. Only if there is a development of language, change in the language, a man like Panini cannot ignore all these things. So that means definitely or most probably Sanskrit was a spoken language during the Panini's time, which underwent some changes by the time Katyayana came to the picture, and that also changed to some extent by the time Patanjali, the writer of the Mahabhashya, came to the picture. That means what was left by Panini was added by Katyayana, and what was left by Katyayana was added by Patanjali. So from Panini to Patanjali, through Katyayana, Sanskrit was a spoken language. Clear? Now, after having discussed the difference between Vedic Sanskrit and classical Sanskrit, now we have to look after another branch, that is Vedic and Iranian. This Iranian branch, as I have told, it has three different branches. We have Old Iranian, Middle Iranian, and New Iranian. Just as Old Aryan, Old Indo-Aryan, New Indo-Aryan, and old Indo-Aryan, Middle Indo-Aryan, New Indo-Aryan. Similarly, we have old Iranian, new Middle Iranian, and new Iranian. You know, just as Vedas are the oldest available literary text of the Aryan, similarly, Avesta, Avesta, Avesta is the oldest text of the Iranians. Avesta means the foundation text, basic text. We have Veda, the name of the text. We have Sanskrit, the name of the language, and we have Devanagari, the lipi of the language, script of the language. Veda written in Sanskrit language in the script of Devanagari. But as regards Avesta, we have the name of the text is Avesta, the name of the text is Avesta, the name of the language is Avesta, the name of the script is also Avesta. Avesta is translated as Upastha. Upastha means foundation text in Sanskrit. If you make a slight change of the Avestan verses, you will see that there is very great similarity, very intimate similarity between Avestan language and Sanskrit language. I recite a verse from the Avesta. असम बहु बहिष्टम अस्ति उस्ता अस्ति उस्ता अम्हाई बहिष्टम असाई असम बहु बहिष्टम अस्ति स चंजस्तु ह रुतम बसु वशिष्टम अस्ति उस्ता अस्ति उस्ता अम्हाई अम्हाई माने अस्ति बहिष्टम अस्ति उस्ता अस्ति उस्ता अम्हाई. सो इफ यू मेक अ स्लाइट चेंज संस्कृत वैदिक संस्कृत Avestan language becomes Sanskrit without any difficulty. Putra becomes Putra. Vedic Ojas, Avesta Ojo. Vedic Anu, Avesta Anu. Vedic Anya, Avesta Anya. Vedic Dadami, Avesta Dadami. Vedic Putra, Avesta Putra. Almost all. Vedic Nebhas, नभस दिशा चंद्र कह नभस नभ वैदिक अस्थि अवस्था अस्त वैदिक यज अवस्था यज वैदिक अपह अवस्था अप वैदिक पिता अवस्था पिता वैदिक पिष्ठामी अवस्था हिष्ट इति वैदिक ज्वस्ता अवस्था जवसा. सो यू बी इन ऑलमोस्ट ऑल केसेस द वैदिक संस्कृत and Avesta Sanskrit are parallel to each other. This Iranian language, which is a part of Aryan language, this Iranian language has three divisions, time divisions. We have Old Iranian, we have Middle Iranian, and Modern Iranian. It is inferred that Old Iranian had much literary output in it. But because of the external aggression, the attack of external enemies, most of the original texts, ancient texts, have been destroyed by burning them. First external attack was by Sikandar in 323 BC. And the second attack was by the Arabs in 6th century, 7th century AD. These two external attacks on the Iranians destroyed most of the valuable literary outputs of that region for all times to come. This old Iranian had two forms. We have in the eastern part and the other in the western part. The Eastern Iranian, as you know, it is also called Avestan. It has only one text called Avesta. This is the Avesta, I believe, is the religious text of the Parsis. Now, Iran is a Muslim state. The Parsis have fled to Surat in Gujarat, in Bombay, in Calcutta, and they are found in very less numbers in India. And they are also worshippers of fire god. Just as Rigveda has its first mantra on Agni, they are also fire worshippers. The temple where they used to worship their god is called as Agiari. Agiari means Agniari. This Avesta was written by Zarathustra or Zoroaster. The language is also called Avesta, or some people call it Avestan. It was the royal language of the ancient Bactria state. This is therefore it is called as ancient Bactrian. Some people wrongly call it Avesta.
सर बिकॉज वी हैव ए क्वेश्चन आंसर डिस्कशन फोरम सो एट द लास्ट मोमेंट मीन्स बिफोर 15 मिनट्स We have to discuss about question and answer, sir. So please, okay. Yes, sir. Tari purvam, mohoday, mohoday. Yes, sir. Tari purvam aham kinchit kathay tum ichha me. Joto hi ite manya manya ha, ganya ganya ha, sanskrita gya ha. Samagam bharta me bas shrutva atra samagata ha santi. Ite samkrute tu hruday taha hardam kardam dhanyavadam samarpayami. Joto hi ite mahanubhava ha santi. Sanskrita khetre ite vidwan sah tata dhurina ha. पंडितः इति वक्तुं शक्नुमः एतेषां वा विषये अहं किं वा कथयितुम् इच्छामि यतो हि सर्वेपि एतेषां विषये सम्यक्तया सर्वमपि जानन्ति तर्हि इदानीम् अस्माकं तत्र प्रश्नोत्तरं कार्यक्रमः वर्तते तर्हि प्रश्नानाम् उच्चारणं मैडम् करिष्यन्ति सूर्यकान्ति प्रधान मैडम् एवम् उत्तरं तु विधास्यन्ति अस्माकं महोदयाः अद्य तु सार नैके नैकविधा विषयान् आधारीकृत्य उक्तवन्तः यथा तावत् वै सो मच डिफरेन्सेस् एमङ्ग् द लेङ्ग्वेजेस् लैक् हौ फोर् पार्ट्स् आफ् लेङ्ग्वेजेस् ही हेज़् सेट् इन् ए गुड् मेनर् देन् अबौट् फोर् प्रिन्सिपल्स् थ्यूरी हेज़् टोल्ड् वै सर् देन् मेनि मोर् थिङ्ग्स् हौ द कुको वर्ड्स् हेज़् कम् ही एक्स्प्लेन् डिङ्ग् डोङ्ग् चक् चक् How these words creates languages, then sadhanataya sabdanam vibhajanam kartum naiva saknuma iti api tai uktam. Then he said that also how all the languages of the world have been grouped in the family. All these things sir have said. So then madam, please ask the questions. Read out the questions. Madam?
यदि छात्राणां कोऽपि प्रश्नो वर्तते पृच्छन्तु
सर् अहमेव पृच्छामि तत्र महोदय तत्र छात्राणां छात्राः एव तत्र नाम प्रश्नान् कुर्वन्ति प्रथमप्रश्नः सर् गार्डिनर् महोदयस्य मतानुसारं भाषायाः का परिभाषा इति निरञ्जन जना इति छात्रः पृच्छति
मतानुसारं
गार्डिनर् महोदयस्य गार्डिनर्
जि ए आर् डि ऐ एन् ई आर्
गार्डिनर्
तस्य मतानुसारेण भाषायाः का परिभाषा
भाषायाः का परिभाषा
अन्यः प्रश्नः
भाषा हि मानवानां सर्वस्य विधिं कथम् भाषा ही मानवानां सर्वश्रेष्ठ निधि कथम जगदीश महाराणा पृच्छति
See, why language is the most precious wealth of the human beings. See, whatever you do, whatever intellectual activity you do, you cannot do without a language. As I've already told, man is different from the animals only in four different spheres. We have only in one sphere, that is dharma. Ahara, with regard to ahara, food, nidra, sleep, bhaya, we are afraid of human beings are afraid of animals and afraid of us. So ahara, nidra, bhaya, and maithuna, we produce children, they also produce their offsprings. So these are the four parameters through which man is equal with animals. Ahara, nidra, bhaya, maithuna, these are the four things which are found common with human beings and animals. So with regard to language only, man is distinct from animals. Whatever activity you do, you can keep it as a record only the language. See, an animal can express his feelings to another animal, but he cannot record it. Only thing, for recording purpose, moreover, man is rational. A man can decide which is ought to be done, which is not to be done. So this can be done only through language. Language is the only thing which creates a history. Language can be preserved, your research can be preserved, your literary output can be preserved. See, Mahabharata written thousands of years before, and it is telecast today. But what were the conversations between animals that can, what are the, how the animals are developing their research, how life, that cannot be recorded. So language is the only tool in the hands of the human beings which helps him to record, to develop, to rewrite, to criticize everything. So an animal cannot criticize another animal. An animal cannot record his own feelings for future generations. Man corrects himself. If something is wrong, a person coming at a later date can correct him, which is not possible with other creatures of the world. That is why language is the only thing that differentiates a man from the animal, and it helps to preserve his own culture, civilization, and his findings. That is why invaluable wealth, language is the invaluable wealth of the human beings.
धन्यवाद सर.
Any other question?
हाँ सर.
About that, these questions do not relate to the topic proper.
हाँ ओके
This is a
सर.
general question.
यस सर, यस सर. सर थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर गिविंग द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चंस. सर देर आर मेनी मोर क्वेश्चन बट वी हैव नो टाइम टू डिस्कस ऑल दिस थिंग्स. सो जस्ट आई वांट टू से समथिंग अबाउट यू सर. सर थैंक थैंक यू वेरी मच
Meral, kindly
सर.
forward this question to me. Kindly forward this question to me.
यस सर,
I shall
यस सर,
post it.
वी कैन फॉरवर्ड सर. सर
Give a link so that I can
सर
write the answer.
Yes, sir. Because in that chat box, sir, we are looking that questions. So, are you, sir, are you able to look that question?
No, I'm not able to look.
सर चैट
Oh,
ओपन कर लिए
sir. Otherwise,
चैट ओपन
sir,
कर आसुनी
साइट रे गुटे सर चैट बॉक्स अच्छे.
आसुनी
चैट बॉक्स रे क्लिक कोला पर सब क्वेश्चन ता जाना पड़ी चार सर.
मैं चैट पर आसुनी गिन छी
मैडम ताले
असल कौन करे
मझीरे गोटे चैट बॉक्स अच्छी सर जो थी नंबर लिखा है लेफ्ट राइट साइड रे आई आइकॉन अच्छी लेफ्ट साइड नंबर कौन से बर्तमान 35 देखो सर
हेलो सर
वेलकम कैंटन करके
हेलो हेलो
सर लाइन पे अच्छा नहीं देखो जी सर यही गले नहीं मुठी गले नहीं
हेलो
सर मुठी गले
ओ यही गले नहीं
हाँ
ओ ओ सर
सर मुठी गले नहीं को एंड कर दियो तुम मुठी गले
सर अपन को म्यूट ही है सर म्यूट माइक बटन को आउ थरे सर क्लिक करंतु अनम्यूट हिबे
हेलो
हां आसिले सर आसिले
हेलो
हां सर
हां हेलो हेलो
हां हां सर आसिले सर सर सुना जाउ छी सर हां हां आ मैडम ताले कोन तो मैडम
सर सर निरंजन जेना पुछती हितनी महोदय न लैंग्वेज ऑफ स्टडी इति पुस्तक किम लिखित अस्ति
कोन कोन पढ़ती दिने पढ़ती जी
हितनी महोदय न लिखी छ
हितनी
हां महोदय न लैंग्वेज ऑफ स्टडी इति पुस्तक किम लिखित अस्ति
बहुरी तत्त्वत प्रवर्तन्ते तो मुख्यतया व्याकरण विषय व्याकरण विषय तत्र वर्तते व्याकरण विषय बहुरी तथ्यांतानि
मोर ये अभिप्राय मान कहार अच्छी आपण मैंने क्वेश्चन करते रिलेटेड सर जो टॉपिक टा पढ़ुंत से रिलेटेड पचारे मान सुविधा हम बिकज अनंत शास्त्र बहुलाश्च विद्या बहुत गुड़ाए अच्छी तो मान एक्स्ट्रा टॉपिक रु ये कले आमको भी ये हम तो टाइम तो आज ही सर ये सेसन को रखापी आउ भी सेसन अच्छी सर तो सर थैंक यू भेरी मच सर आसिक बहुमूल्य समय देखिए बहुत किसी शिखेले सर
हाँ सर आपण बहुत अल्प समय मध्ये बहुत गुडिये कोर्स पिलांको शिकले सेते सर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर
आईडिया पाई जान
हां
सर सर थैंक यू सो मच बोली भी बहुत पिला कोचन
अल्प समय मध्ये से बहुत किसी जानि पाथिले सर
थैंक यू हला
हां सर
थैंक यू थैंक थैंक यू सर
सर सर धन्यवाद सर
थैंक्स अ लॉट सर
थैंक्स
तो हमें इस सेशन तक वेब रखी बैठे हो थैंक्स टू ऑल फॉर जॉइनिंग वंस अगेन
ओके थैंक यू फोन करिया कॉलेज मु कटु छी बाबरी कितने थैंक यू सर
The class is over now.
ट्राए कला जॉइन कर ସେଇଟା ହିଁ ସାର୍ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ହେଇଗଲା। ଓକେ ସାର୍ ଥ୍ୟାଙ୍କ ୟୁ ସାର୍। ତା
କାଲି ଅଛି 3ଟାରେ
ଓଡ଼ିଆ। ହଁ ସାର୍, ହଁ ସାର୍, ଆଜ୍ଞା
ରେଡି ହେଇଥିବେ ଆଉ।
ଆଜ୍ଞା ଆଜ୍ଞା ସାର୍, ଠିକ୍ ଅଛି ସାର୍, ରହିଲି ସାର୍, ନମସ୍କାର।